Well, I am here to speak of a very dark and tragic story. You already understood that Euro is a monster, contradicting all the rules of both modern money, modern economy. So, the problem is, why is such an absurd system exists at all? I was told that in your country, like in mine, some people believe that if we get rid of the euro, Italy or France should be back to the state of the poorest part of Africa, Zimbabwe. But the real economy in the Eurozone is already in the state of Zimbabwe. For instance, some short data on France, because the French invented and imposed the euro system a very long time ago. In France, the true amount of unemployment is around 60% of the active people, which is obviously enormous. And we have a true rate of inflation of 7 or 8%. So we don't have full employment and we don't have price stability. It means that all official data in Europe are lies. So I shall start my true speech by a quotation from the chief executive of the French Ministry of Finance. By the way, he is a monk of the Order of Santo Benedict. And the chief of the French Opus Dei. And by the way, the European Commission is entirely controlled, like the French government, by the Opus Dei. So, I try to discuss with him. He told me, yes, the French economy is dead, but not enough. He told me, Professor, you should understand why the European system exists. What we want is to destroy forever the people. we want forever to create a new kind of European people accepting sufferance, poverty, which could accept wages lower than in China. And it will be the core of my intervention. The euro system was never planned to be a monetary union. It was not even planned as a neoliberal agenda. The neoliberal economics, American style, was and is still completely ignored by the ruling European elite. When you think that even for the leader of the French Socialist Party, President Obama is a Marxist. So, what is the euro? A new totalitarian social order, which was planned a long time ago in the interwar period and completed by the regime of François Mitterrand. In that new order, there will be no more sovereign state. The state has to vanish. At least the state rooted into democracy, parliament, republic. In the new order, power should be entirely transferred to those who deserve it, which means some elite capitalist class, technocrats, enjoying absolute power of control. And in the first part of my interventions, I shall try briefly to explain the story of the planning of the European Monetary Union. It started in the interwar period in the most reactionary, traditionalist parts of the French ruling class, with some support from an Italian philosopher, Julius Evola, the very one who accused Mussolini of being too soft to the people, and who accused Adolf Hitler of being too pro-people. In a second part, I shall try to explain that the so-called sovereign debt crisis is obviously an event who never happened in history. But such a crisis has been carefully planned by the architects of the European system. What they had in mind was to privatize the state. And since they believed that the state, at least the state with democracy, was always wasting real wealth. It's obvious that the state being forced to borrow money, the state debt should be looked at as bad debts and thereby the state should be completely enslaved to the so-called bonds market, which is exactly what is happening now. In a last part, I shall try to prove that there is not the least way of amending the system, because as a social order, it has its logic, and those who control the system will never accept any kind of change, especially any kind of intervention of the European Central Bank. Only, indeed, if those interventions aim at increasing the bank's wealth. So, the sole possibility of saving the European society is to get rid of that system. The private sector, capitalist sector in Europe is now dead. To quote Michael Hudson, a pure parasite, leaders of the capitalist sector are no more interested into the real economy. They are rentiers. So, European capitalism is dying. Growth is for 5 or 6 years in France, minus 3 or 4% a year. As for the euro, it's as I wrote, thanks to an invitation by my colleague Stephanie Kelton, in long time ago, a false money, and I wrote an article, a false money against the real economy, and indeed, it destroyed the real economy. But first, let us briefly explain the origin of such an absurd system. There are two stages into the planning of the euro system. The first, in the interwar period and during 1940-1943. And the second stage, the achievement of the system was, I must say, the masterwork of the regime of François Mitterrand. So we start in the mid-30s with people like Schuman, Jean Monnet. Schuman wrote that in 1927 we need to create Europe as a new order rooted into tradition. Saving Europe from decadence. Decadence for the pro-Europeans means socialism, revolution, Protestants, Jews, Marxism, free access to health and education, abortions, homosexuality, etc., etc. And, which is extremely interesting, for the early pro-Europeans, what they wished was a system completely opposed to the United States society they hated. And the European elite was more hating the United States society of consumptions, shopping malls, than they hated USSR. And now it is exactly the same. So, what was required to build Europe? To abolish the state, to force a permanent deflation by squeezing public expenditures. It could help to transfer the power to a super class of technocrats on a supranational scale. But for those early Europeans, what meant Europe? It means a condominium between France, Germany, and a colonial empire, including Southern Europe and Eastern Europe. They were absolutely explicit on this problem. But how could we suppress the state by depriving the state of any power on money? All of them were fanatical followers of Friedrich Hayek, the most right-wing Austrian economics of that time. So, Europe should rely on a supranational currency entirely controlled by a sovereign central bank enjoying absolute power to ration the state. Indeed, they finally, what they wished was to impose the future European currency as a super gold standard. The first blueprint of the Treaty of Maastricht was written by a French economist, François Perroux, in 1943, with the full support of a treaty passed between the Reich government and the French pro-Nazi regime of that time. And the new treaty, which has been decided by President Sarkozy and Madame Merkel, is exactly the blueprint of François Perroux, 1943. Those people were against the traditional gold standard because they believed that the gold standard had not allowed a total abolition of the power of the state to spend. So euro should be a super gold standard. So it was the first stage. But for some time, the European project was maybe in the backwards because all his supporters were more pro-Hitlerian than Adolf Hitler himself. So we had to wait. The regime of François Mitterrand. I could speak on this question because I had been conscripted by the chief advisor of François Mitterrand, who, by the way, was a fanatical right-winger, hating the modern world, hating the United States, a monarchist who said, "I hate the poor." So Jacques Attali was de facto the Prime Minister of France. And Attali was in charge with a lot of former Marxists turned to supporters of the new regime, of drafting a more sustainable version of the euro system. But they had in mind the same vision. We must destroy shopping malls, consumption shopping malls were for them a pure infamy. People should accept to be poor. I remember debates at the secret commission who was in charge of the campaign of Mitterrand. Mitterrand had to win the support of the then Parti Communist. France had a communist party. Now, no more. So, I was charged to write some modest Keynesian, I would say, modern money program. But Attali was asked by those who funded Mitterrand campaign. And who was the major funders that seized Manhattan Bank? And two other American banks. But we never gave you money to get a program of full employment. Attali said, "I have the commitment of our dear future president. As soon as we could, we will destroy. We will cut. We will deflate the economy. Real wages will collapse. And what we have in mind is a total collapse of the share of labor income in the French society. And how to get that? By the Treaty of Maastricht and the creation of the euro system. I shall end this intervention by emphasizing, First, the lies. It happened that I was quite close to François Mitterrand. He was, a long time ago, boyfriend of my mother before the war. My mother told me François lies so well that he could believe that he is for the people. So François Mitterrand, during the sole debate on the Treaty of Maastricht, dared to say, answering a question from a student, I can swear there is not the least independent central bank in the Treaty of Maastricht. Second point, the core principle of the European treaties was the privatization of the state, was to oblige the state to borrow money by selling bonds to private banks. So, the state, like any corporation, but a corporation with a very pure reputation, had to beg money to banks at the rates of interest decreed by banks. So, finally, the Treaty of Maastricht and the following Growth and Stability Pact, a very weird name. The true name should have been Destruction and Instability Pact. So the true, what they had in mind was that finally the state will be completely enslaved to private banks and so will be obliged to cut and cut and cut expenditures. And it is exactly what happened. And finally, lies continue. To be brief, yes, the share of state debt in the assets of major French German banks is below 5%. Banks are losing money not because of state debt, but because of the total collapse of the real economy. And second point, I am horrified when people say, oh, poor banks, the Greek government lied but it is absurd. Everybody was aware of the true state of the Greek economy. ninety percent of the Greek debt is held, like the Italian, by French and German banks. So everybody knew. And by the way, what is happening now, thanks to the new treaty, is, if it is indeed finally endorsed, a total abdication of states, of fiscal policy, and any kind of social policy. And indeed, the dream of the new order will be achieved. So, now, the problem of rulers of the system is how to maintain the control of society. Of this, they are afraid. Because there is no debate. Official economists in Germany, France, most European countries are completely corrupt. If I dare say, they are official prostitutes, financed by grants, by European institutions. So they never debate on the infamy and collapse of the European system. Thank you.